Welcome back to the show, folks. My first guest tonight is a talented actor and producer. You know him from Boogie Nights, The Departed, and Lone Survivor. He now stars in Patriots Day.
Yeah, now I know what you're doing. That's a finish line, yeah?
You said 245?
Correct.
It's gotta be Crate and Barrel.
Crate and Barrel, anybody?
Checking Crate and Barrel.
Yes, sir. I see you, 2:44 p.m. The hat's got a golf logo along with the number 3.
Okay.
2:42 p.m. Whiskey Steakhouse.
Whiskey Steak.
Whiskey Steakhouse.
Whiskey Steakhouse.
It's a man wearing aviators. Looks like they know each other.
Please welcome Mark Wahlberg.
Oh, Mark Wahlberg.
Nice to meet you.
It's nice to meet you.
I'm nice to meet another Wahlberg, because we had Donnie on not that long ago for Blue Bloods here on CBS. Uh-huh. And what a delight your brother is. We really connected. He really raised the Wahlberg bar. So no pressure, but a fantastic guest.
Wow.
Fantastic guest.
Thank you.
Yeah,
I appreciate that.
Yeah. Does he ask about me? Does he talk about me or
anything
like that?
Didn't mention you at all.
Doesn't mention me at all?
Didn't mention
okay,
you
he
at
said
all.
Nice things about you.
I don't believe that either. No, you know, it's one of those things. Being the youngest of 9, I got tortured by my brothers and sisters. So it's nice that we have a good relationship now.
So did you get, like, beaten up by your brothers?
Yeah, until I was, like, 12, and then I started, you know, I turned the tables.
You beat up your older brothers?
All of them.
That's not allowed. You're the youngest child. You're the youngest child. You have to respect your elders.
We'd literally be in the kitchen, and my mother would be like, what are you doing? I'm like, what do you think I'm doing? She's like, you're beating up your brother. And I'm like, yeah. And she's like, in front of his wife and kids. And you're 35 years old now. Enough already. I think you got revenge. All right, stop.
So. Okay, so youngest of 9. How many boys, how many girls?
6 boys, 3 girls.
Okay.
And then my dad had 3 or 4 somewhere else. Before us.
Okay, all right, yeah. Do you know where else, or is it just sort of
I met
legend?
A few of them.
Okay, nice.
I met my brother Scott. Okay. I think there's 2 Donnies.
2 Donnies?
Yeah. So
you should make them fight in a pit.
Yeah.
There can be only one.
Well,
there can be only
one. I knew of only one, but.
Yeah. Well, I'm one of 11 kids. I'm the youngest of 11.
Wow.
8 boys, 3 girls. Wow. And
very rare.
Yeah, pretty rare these days, yeah.
Common where I come from, but.
Great to be the youngest, though, right?
When you start to get into your teens. You know what? It was.
You got away with a lot.
Well, I did, but then I ended up going to jail. So that's not that's not good because you know, my parents spent a lot of time just trying to put food on the table, so I was left to my own devices, and that was hanging around with the wrong crowd.
Yeah. My mom was like, by the time she got to me, she was like, 10 fingers, 10 toes, you go outside.
Yeah, it's funny because, you know, my mom would tell me the stories of my dad when you know, she was ready to give birth. He'd drop her off and say, pick me up when you're done. Mm-hmm. And, you know, here I am curled up in the hospital chair about this size of this, trying to sleep for 3 days. Wow. My wife is giving birth to our 4 children.
Can you name them from the top to the bottom? Can you do them fast?
What, like?
Your brothers and sisters, can you, like, you know, do you want to do it, want to race? I'll do 11 from the top to bottom, and you do your 9. Ready?
You want to go top to bottom or bottom to top?
I can only do top to bottom. Well, you can go bottom to top. It doesn't matter to me. I don't know if you're...
Right.
Okay, you
all
can right. go yep. bottom to top, and I'll yep. go top to whatever you choose.
Yep.
Okay, ready? Well, 1, 2, 3, and we'll go.
Yep.
1, 2, 3.
Donnie Jimmy, Andy, Mary, Bill, Mark, Tom, Jerry,
Paul, Peter, and Steven. Oh.
You have more.
No one's ever beaten me.
Or you have more.
No one's ever beaten me.
Yeah.
It doesn't matter. No one's ever beaten me. Congratulations.
Sir, thank you, sir.
I'm humbled.
Well, you haven't seen the Ted movies. I talk really fast. I'm good with names and rapid fire.
There are a lot of great movies about Boston, and you're in all of them. Except Good Will Hunting. That's the only one you're not in.
And The Brinks Job is pretty good, too.
Okay, okay. When you're in one of these movies about Boston, and we watch you in the movie, we go, that's a really good Boston accent. That makes sense. He's from Boston. Mm-hmm. When the other people talk, though...
Yeah,
we go, wow, they should not be in a scene.
That's not
with good. Mark Wahlberg if they're trying that accent. What do you do on set? Because it's one of the hardest accents to get right. What do you do when you're on set and somebody's like completely shanking the Boston accent? How do you control yourself?
Well, in a movie like this, like a movie like Ted, it's fine. It's a comedy, right? We can figure it out. A movie like this, it really relies on its authenticity and accuracy. So we would say, okay, you get one more try, and if not, we will dub you in post.
What?
Yeah, or don't do the accent, you know, because it's not good when it's bad. And well, Pete likes to improvise, and a lot of people come in, they have dialect coaches, they know their lines, mm-hmm. and as soon as Pete says, okay, throw the script out the window, we're going to improvise, people start to really get nervous. Becomes an issue. But with Michelle Monaghan, she did a fantastic job on the accent, and I was there for her when we started improvising. And John Goodman is the only other person who really does an accent. Other than that, mm-hmm. we cast pretty much all Bostonians.
Well, that brings us to the movie, because Patriots Day, for those of you who don't know yet, it's about April 15th, 2013, the Boston bombing, the Boston Marathon. It's an important story to the nation, but a particularly important story to your hometown. Where were you when that happened?
I was not in Boston, and then I heard what happened. I immediately went to Boston the next day, and you know, it was incredible seeing my city like that. It was pretty much deserted, and just had such an eerie feeling. You know, Boston is such a small place. Everybody knows somebody who was directly affected by this. And but what was amazing was how Boston responded. Not just law enforcement, first responders. Everybody came together. You know, when those explosions went off, you saw people running immediately towards the problem. People from all walks of life. And that made me extremely proud to be a Bostonian. I wanted to share that, as well as the other positive and inspiring stories of the victims and their families, and also the survivors.
It was a tragic day. A shocking and heartbreaking day, but I think so many people, certainly I watching it, were moved by the response that Boston had. People stepped up in Boston, mm-hmm. even the people running the race. There were people that day who ran a marathon and then ran another 2 miles to a hospital to give blood. Mm-hmm. You know, Boston was a beautiful place on that terrible day. I understand that you almost didn't make this movie. You weren't sure whether you wanted to be in it. Why were you on the fence about doing this?
Well, obviously it's an extremely sensitive subject, but you know, there were three movies being talked about at various stages of development, and they were going to make the movie. So I said, you know what, I'm not going to let somebody else come into my town who's not going to handle it with the respect and sensitivity in which it deserves, because of the amount of violence and carnage. You know, this could be something that could become gratuitous and really, you know, having these people be exploited. And with Pete Berg, who I did Lone Survivor with, as well as Deepwater Horizon, I knew how Pete would handle this, and with the amount of care and respect that it deserves. So I said, you know what, I'm going to tell the story, and I'm going to get it right, and I'm going to make sure that people know what Boston Strong means and make my community proud. And you know, we also have, you know, you look at what happened in Cairo on Sunday, and these things just continue to happen all over the world, and we have to continue to promote that message that love will always win, and that no matter what happens, we'll get back up and we'll hold hands and we'll fight for each other. And that message is important, so.
Let me ask you one other thing about Boston, is that people from there seem like they're never impressed with other people from there. Like
it's surprising that you noticed that. Absolutely.
Yeah, because I've noticed that.
I don't
think
there's ever been one good thing written about me in a Boston newspaper.
So you don't impress the people back home?
Well, you know what, the people that matter, you know, for me, being able to turn my life, I haven't gotten into so much trouble when I was a kid, being able to turn my life around. You know, I'd gone to Copley High, but I didn't go past the ninth grade, and that's probably 200 yards away from the finish line. I was able to go back and get my diploma at 42, and I've inspired kids growing up in neighborhoods like that, that if I can accomplish what I've accomplished, there's no reason why they can't do anything, but you got to put the work in. You got to do the right thing, you got to earn it and work for it, and great things will happen.
All right. Well, thank you so much for being here. Merry
Thanks
Christmas.
Thanks for having me. Appreciate it. Thank you very much.
Have a good holiday. Patriots Day is in theaters December 21st. Mark Wahlberg, everybody. We'll be right back with Lee Daniels. Stick around.